It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who could make me be true, could make me be blue, or even be glad just to be sad thinking of you. Some others I've seen might never be mean, might never be cross or try to be boss, but they wouldn't do for nobody.
This is Charles Yoakum. Charles used to be a welder, but he dreamed of becoming an actor. His personal interests were as insane as his furniture designs. They included Shakespeare, the European Art Nouveau movement, and cabinet making. Charles incorporated design elements from Chinese, Islamic, Louis Sullivanist, French Art Nouveau, and British arts and crafts. Charles Yoakum played at every theater imaginable. Then, one night, as he performed one of Shakespeare's famous plays, Macbeth, a shiny piece of metal caught his eye and instantly felt sparked. As he had dated other metals in his past, he had never seen a metal as lovely and smart as Anna the Shiny Metal. Anna the Shiny Metal, a detective mystery novelist, and Charles the Oak Tree, a struggling actor, became inseparable. However, to make their love a reality, he would stop his acting career and become a furniture maker in order to seek the approval of her father. Her interest in science and poetry was the inspiration that led to the metal design element of the desk of chairs in 1898, which is inspired by the microscopic image of a cellular structured oak. A few decades later, in Dayton, Ohio, the chair was found in an attic during an estate sale held by an elderly woman. In August 2006, the granddaughter of the elderly woman brought the chair to the Antique Roadshow in Philadelphia. The appraiser was able to inform her of the history of the chair, and to her surprise, it was one of the original artistic chairs made by Charles Rolfe. The chair was appraised for $80,000 to $120,000. The popularity of Charles Rolfe was an inspiration for many artists after his time. One of them is Rowan and Erwin Borolek, brothers who designed the Vegetal chair in 2008. Similar to Rolfe, they incorporated the trend of whiplash curves, which is referred back to the Art Nouveau era. Today, the desk oak chair is owned by the Metropolitan Museum of Art. The Metropolitan Museum of Art is one of the world's premier cultural institutions, boasting a collection of millions of artworks and decorative objects attended by some of the nation's foremost scholars and conservators.